with Andre's helmet, and then we can tell a little bit to all the people what I'm doing here all the weekend. First thing what I do when the rider comes back, I take off the visor, like that. And I can check the inside of there if there's any damage inside the visor for the rider. If there's some kind of damage, I will throw away the visor and the rider gets a new visor. If there is no extra marks in it, I would just use an air to clean that. While the visor is off, I can just clean the helmet, take away the flies and all the things. I'm just using water with some dish soap, so there will be no chemicals inside, because they will affect the plastics. So while I'm cleaning the whole helmet, I can have a look if every function is still working on the helmet. So if there's anything not working, I can replace that part. Starting to make one tear off. Just like that. To keep the tear off in one place. Take away the foil. Another tape on there.
And how many helmets do you have to prepare during the race weekend?
I have about something like 18 riders, and some of the riders they have 2 or 3 helmets. So I will be probably doing like somewhere around 50 a day, because they come back in 2 or 3 times, and so it's a lot of work. Yeah. Now the first tear off, I need to make I need to fold it into a special way, because the rider we don't want to have the rider take off 2 tear offs in one time. So I will be cutting it. Throw away, that it's not possible to take out 2. So the first tear off will stick under this post, and the wind will come in and it will open, so the rider can take off also this tear off. So now the second one goes on. Most of the riders they use 2 tear offs, sometimes 3. But it depends on the rider, what they want.
And does a ride take part also for the Ladder Championship, or just World Superbike?
We do help all the sponsored riders within the Rail Majora, but also if non-sponsored riders, if they come and they have a problem on the helmet, we're always helping them out to get them safe on the track, of course. So yeah, we have, I will go to the World Superbike, and we have Toru, he's my colleague, he's doing the MotoGP. And we have Peter Berger for the Formula One. So that's it. Now it's done.
Oui, oui, et bien écoute, plante ta toile dedans,
mets
ta
toile pour
côté.
Oui. Damage anything.
And is that helmet and the same as we can buy in shop?
Yes,
or
yes,
different?
Yes. Now all the helmets within our ride, they're the same, also for the riders, of course. And because we believe that there's no difference in a rider's safety head or safety of another person. Sometimes the interior is a little bit different because that's only the fitting for the rider, but for the rest it's complete same helmet. There really is a difference within the testing and everything, because the normal testing, when the impact is there, it's about 28 kilometers an hour, and well, as you know, a lot of people they ride 100, so those values are not very different from each other. So we wanted to tell the people that you know, there are brands, they know exactly where the testing is going to be, so they make the helmet stronger there. But if you are a little bit offside of that testing area, that helmet will fail. And we wanted to tell the people that there really is a difference between an RI helmet and another brand's helmet, because that's one of the biggest things that makes a difference.
It's important to have a good helmet.
Yeah, it's important, and people need to know these things, because when people buy a helmet in the shop and it's like a one cheap one brand, they think okay, but it is approved and so it should be safe, and
yeah,
still has a lot of spots of areas that the helmet is not safe, and when they with an RI helmet they're all safe.
Yeah.
No?